In this three-part Blender tutorial series, I'm going to show you how to create realistic rocky mountains in Blender. And to create the rocky mountains, we're going to be using a built-in Blender add-on called the A.N.T. landscape. And so by the end of this three-part tutorial series, we'll have this finished artwork here of these Rocky Mountains. And I definitely recommend using the Cycles rendering engine for this tutorial to get more realism. So in part one, we are going to be creating the mountain objects using Blender's built-in A.N.T. landscape add-on. Then in part two, we're going to be making the mountains more detailed, and we'll also do the lighting and set up the HDRI sky environment in the background. And then in part three, we're going to be doing all of the materials, and then we will render the scene and do some compositing to get the finished artwork. Now, if creating realistic environments is something that you're interested in and something that you want to get better at, then I'd highly recommend checking out CG Boost's course on mastering 3D environments in Blender. I've reviewed the course myself and I can highly recommend it. It's a really great course for learning how to create realistic environments in Blender. And the course goes into so much more detail about creating realistic environments in Blender, much more than this tutorial series. And if you are interested in purchasing the course, I do have an affiliate link to the course in the video description. So if you purchase the course through my link, then I will earn a small commission, and that's a great way to help support me and this channel. One thing that I really like about the course is that it's very well organized, and the entire course is split up into many small videos. So if you're low on time or you're just searching for a specific topic, you can jump to that video in the course. Now, this course is definitely not created for complete beginners. This course is geared for intermediate users, because in the course videos, they're not going to show you every single button that's pressed or every shortcut key, but they do go over the general workflow, and that is much better for intermediate users. But as long as you have the basics of Blender down, so knowing the basic shortcut keys and knowing the basic 3D workflows, then you can definitely follow along with this course. Now, the course covers multiple different ways to create environments in Blender. So the course covers how to create environments with the A.N.T. landscape add-on, but it also shows you how to create environments using the procedural displacements, as well as textures, and also how to create environments using geometry nodes. And it also covers a few other methods, like using some other Blender add-ons. The course also shows you how to create multiple different environments, such as a realistic snowy mountain, a desert scene, some Arctic glaciers, landscapes with trees, and even water, and also how to create clouds in Blender, as well as a few other things like some different add-on recommendations, how to add plants and vegetation to your scene, and also how to use the geometry nodes in Blender to create environments. So I highly recommend this course, and if you'd like to learn more about it, then definitely check it out with the link in the description, and that is an affiliate link, so if you purchase the course through my link, then I'll earn a small commission, and that's a great way to help support me as well. So in this tutorial, I'm going to be using three different free resources online, and I'll have the links in the description if you'd like to download them. So to get some nice realistic lighting and to get some clouds in the background, I'm going to be using this free HDRI from polyhaven.com, and I'm going to be downloading the 8K HDR version. Now, usually I download the 1K version because if it's 1K, then the resolution will be smaller, and this way it'll use less memory when rendering, and it'll render a bit faster. But because we're going to be previewing the HDRI in the background, I do want it to be a bit higher quality, because if we download the 1K version, it will look a bit pixelated. So I'm going to be downloading the 8K HDR version, and then you can just download this from Polyhaven. And then I'm also going to be using two different textures. So this first texture here is the Rock 028, and this is from ambientcg.com, and I'm going to be downloading the 4K JPEG version. So again, links in the description if you'd like to download this, and we'll be putting this on the mountain. And then to add a bit more variation to the mountain texture, I'm also going to be downloading this Rock Moss 001, and this is a free texture from 3D Textures. So again, links in the description if you'd like to download it. So right down here, you can scroll down, and then you can click on download all the maps. And this will take you to a Google Drive folder, and you can just click on download all to download all the maps. Or if you want to, you can just download the ones that we want to use. So I'm going to be using the normal map and the base color and also the roughness. So I'll just be using those three maps in this tutorial. So here we are in a new scene in Blender, and I'll have my screencast keys right down here in the corner if you want to see what buttons I'm pressing. So the first thing that we need to do is enable the A.N.T. landscape add-on. So to do that, let's click right here on edit, And then we're going to open up Blender's preferences. And then right over here on the add-ons tab, you can go here to the search and you can type in land. And we just want to turn on the add mesh ANT landscape add-on. So just click on the check mark to turn that on, and then you can close the user preferences. So now that the add-on is turned on, I'm going to start by pressing the A key to select everything, and let's press X, and then I'm going to click on delete. So to add the landscape, I'm going to press Shift A, and we're going to go here to Mesh, and then all the way down here, you're going to click on Landscape. And so this landscape add-on is going to generate landscapes for us. So I'm going to press the period on the numpad to zoom into the landscape. Now to edit the landscape, you can click right here to open up the landscape settings. So right above me, click on the arrow there, and this is going to give you all the different settings for the landscape add-on. So there's a bunch of different settings that you can play around with, and we will be changing some of these. But if you go right up here to the operator presets, there's actually a bunch of different really cool presets that you could check out. So I'm just going to go through some of these. There's some really cool ones here. That's not really a landscape, that's just an abstract one. But there's like this dunes one here. That is pretty cool. There's also this mountain 2, that's pretty cool. And there's also a mountain 1. And there's even a volcano preset, that is super cool. There's also a river one, so I can click on river, and you can see it's gonna generate a landscape with a river. So there's a bunch of different presets that you can check out, but for this tutorial, I'm gonna add the canyon. And we're gonna edit this to make it look more like the edge of a rocky mountain. Now, if for some reason you click away or kind of move the object around, you can see that the settings are going to go away. And so to get the settings back, you can just click on X and then delete, and then you can press Shift A again and go down here and add the landscape. And you can see it's going to add the same landscape. Or instead of doing that, what you can also do is just press the N key to open up the side panel, and I can click over here on the Create tab. And make sure you have the object selected when you do that, and you can see it's going to show you all of the different settings. Now, you might need to click on the refresh button. So for instance, if I want to change the random seed, I could turn this up and then I could click on the refresh button, and then it's going to change the seed and update that. But I'm going to press the N key to close the side panel, and I will press X and delete this. I am just going to press Shift A and add the landscape add-on. And then right over here, if you click on the arrow to open this up, there are all these settings right here. So the first thing that I want to change is the subdivisions. So right here we have subdivisions Y and subdivision X. And so this is going to determine the amount of detail or the geometry of the landscape. So what I'm going to do is click with my mouse and then drag down and then let go. And this way I can change both values at the same time. And I'm going to turn this up to 300 so it's a bit more detailed. But I don't want to turn it up too much because if you turn it up too much, it'll start to get kind of laggy, but I do want to turn it up to 300 so that it is a bit more detailed. Now, if I click right here and drag down on this bar, I'm going to go all the way down here to the bottom. And you can see that there is a falloff setting. So the falloff setting is going to make it so that the end of the landscape just becomes flat. So right now the falloff is just set to X, and that is because we were using the canyon preset. So if I click here on the falloff, I could turn it to none, and this way there's not going to be any falloff, so you can see the entire landscape has the bumpy environment. But I want to have a falloff around the entire landscape, so if I click on the falloff here, I want to change this to X and Y. And this way there will be a falloff around the entire environment, so the environment becomes flat on the edges. Now if I scroll up a little bit, there is this mix factor right here. And if I change the mix factor, it will be a little bit laggy. So what I'm going to do is actually go right up here, and on the subdivisions X and Y, I'm going to click, drag down, and then let go to change both values. And I'm just going to turn these subdivisions to 100 for now, so that it is lower detail, and then we will turn up the geometry later. So if I now go right down here to the mix factor is going to blend this effect type. So if I turn the mix factor up, you can see it's going to bring the mountains down, or if I make the mix factor a smaller number, it's going to bring the mountains up. So I'm going to turn my mix factor to a -0.6, just a -0.6, and now you can see kind of on the top of the mountains, it is a little bit flat. And then I can also drag the bar up here, and I want to go here to the random seed. And so you can play around with the random seed to get a seed that you like. And I'm going to use a random seed of 6 because I think the random seed of 6 looks pretty nice. So we're going to be putting the camera about here. And so this way, this big mountain will be kind of on the side, and you'll be able to see some of these mountains, and then we'll have some other mountains farther away in the background. But you can use whatever random seed you want. So there's so many other settings that you can play around with. For instance, there is a noise size, and that's going to change the size of the mountain. And there's a bunch more settings here. You could use the soft instead of hard, and of course there's a bunch of different presets. But I'm going to keep this how it is. I do want to turn these subdivisions up though, so I'm going to click and then drag down and then let go to change both values at the same time. And so I'm going to turn this to 300 so that it has much more geometry, and this way it'll be more detailed. So that is looking much better. So I'm now done creating the landscape, so I can click on the arrow to hide the landscape settings. And then also I don't need the timeline, so I'm going to close it. So what I'm going to do is bring my mouse right over here when the crosshair appears, and I can click and drag up and then drag down and let go to close the timeline. Let's now save this Blender file. So I'm going to click on File and let's click on Save As. And I'm going to save this as RockyMountain.blend in a folder with my files, and I'll click on Save As. So then as you're working on the project, you can press Ctrl S to save the Blender file. Now I want to model this much closer to the real life scale in Blender so that the realism is a bit better and the depth of field is more accurate and things like that. So the default primitive objects in Blender are about the average human height. So if I press Shift A, go here to Mesh and add a cube, the default scale of the default cube in Blender is about the average human height. And so this environment is actually very small. So I'm just going to hit X to delete, and let's delete this cube. So I'm going to click on this environment here, and then I'm going to press S to scale, and I'm going to type in 20 and then enter. So we're going to scale it up 20 times, and so now it is a much bigger environment, and it's much closer to the real life scale in Blender. And then I want to apply the scale, so this is the object's new default scale. So with the object selected, you can press Control A, and I want to click on scale. And that way this is now the object's new default scale. All right, so I now want to create another environment, and that's going to be the mountains in the background. So what I'm going to do with this landscape selected is I'll just press the H key, and that is going to hide it from the view so it's still in our scene. We can press Alt H to get it back, but I'm just going to press H to hide it for now to get it out of the way. So I'll press Shift A, let's go to Mesh, and I can add another landscape. And I can press the period on the numpad to zoom into it. And then right behind me, I can click on the little add landscape settings. And you can see that it's going to give us the same presets as the other mountain. So I want to reset this to the default settings. So if I click here on the operator presets, I'm going to click on restore operator defaults. And then I might just need to click on the car icon right here. And that is going to do an automatic refresh. So it's going to refresh it. So now we have the default landscape. So I want this landscape to be kind of in the background, kind of on the horizon, and so I want to make it much longer. So right here on this mesh size X, I can turn this up and it's going to make it longer. So I'm going to turn this to 5, and this way the landscape will be longer and it'll be better for putting on the horizon. And then right here on the subdivisions, I do want to turn the subdivisions up going sideways so that it has more geometry, because if I hold down the Z button and go into wireframe, you can see that the geometry is actually stretched a bit because we changed the mesh size. So on the subdivisions X, I want to turn this to 200 so that it has more geometry going back and forth. And then on the subdivisions Y, I can just turn this to 100. So now it is going to have more geometry going back and forth. Now this environment might look a little bit low poly, but we are going to be pretty far away from it, and so we don't actually need that much geometry. Now if we go here to the noise type, I want to change this noise type. So there's a bunch of different noise types you can play around with, but I want to change my noise type to the shattered H terrain. So change it to the shattered H terrain here on the noise type, and you can see this is going to give you a bunch of different mountains, and it kind of has some little creases here in between the mountains, and that kind of looks like little valleys in between the mountains, or maybe like some rivers. And it also looks like a bunch of different little mountains in the background. Now I do want to see a bit more mountains, so if you go right here to the noise size, I just want to drag this down a bit so that you can see more mountains. So I'm holding down the shift key and then dragging the noise size, and I'm going to make the value smaller, and why I'm holding down the shift key is because it makes my movements more sensitive, so it's easier to drag the value. And I just want to make the noise size a bit smaller, maybe something like that, so you can see more of the mountains. Now if I drag this down to see more of the settings, I do want to change this offset right here. So if I hold down the shift key and then drag this offset, I want to bring it up so that the mountains are a bit taller. So just maybe something like that. Maybe that's a little bit too high, so bring that down a bit. And you can also change this height right here. So if the mountains are a little bit too spiky, you can bring it down. So I'll bring it down maybe to something like that, maybe a little bit smaller so the mountains are just a bit less high. And you can turn the offset up to make the landscape all higher. Now I also don't want any fall off on the x-axis going back and forth, but I do want fall off on the y-axis. So right here on the fall off, let's click on this, and I'm going to change this just to y. And so this way there is going to be a fall off on the front and bottom, but not on the sides, and so there'll be more mountains. Alright, so I'm done creating those mountains, so I can just click on the arrow here to close these settings. And then again, I want to model this much closer to the real life scale in Blender, so I'm going to hit S to scale, and then I'm going to type in 10 and enter. So we're going to scale it up by 10 times. And then I will press Control A, and I'm going to click on scale to apply the scale, so this is now the object's new default size. And I can now press Alt-H to unhide the other environment. Now I didn't actually realize this until just recently, but when I was preparing for the tutorial, I actually rendered the 3D environment from this view, but if you press 1 on the numpad to go to front view, this is actually the front view in the 3D viewport. But because of how the HDRI environment lighting was, I rendered the scene from this view over here. So what I'm actually going to do is select this mountain object here, the mountain ranges which are in the horizon, and these are going to appear as though they're in the background of the scene. So I'm going to press G to grab, and then I'm going to click with my mouse wheel and just bring this over on the y-axis, and I'm actually going to bring it forward, because if you press 1 on the numpad, that's going to go to front view, so this is actually the front view, but I'm going to have the camera rendering from this view. So I'm actually going to move here to the back view, and then we might as well add a camera now, so I'm going to press Shift A, and let's go down here and add a camera. And then I just want to move the camera to about where I want it to be, so we will move the camera around later, but for now I'm just gonna bring my view to kind of about here, and then what I'm gonna do is press Control Alt Numpad 0, and Control Alt Numpad 0 is gonna bring the camera to where we are. And I can also press G to grab, bring the camera down a little bit, and I'll just place it there for now. So let's press Control S to save the Blender file. And then if I click on these mountains here, I'll press the 0 on the numpad to go back into the camera view, and I do think these mountains could be scaled up a little bit, so I'm going to hit S to scale, let's hit Z to bring it up on the Z-axis, make it a bit bigger, maybe scale it up even a bit more, and kind of move it over and just kind of place it about there. And then I can press Control A again, and I can apply the scale, so this is now the object's new default size. Now as well as having some mountains which are very far back, I want to have some mountains which are a bit closer. So I'm going to press Shift D to duplicate, and I'm going to click with my mouse wheel to bring it over on the y-axis and place it there. And then I want these mountains to look different from these mountains. So what I'm going to do is hit R to rotate, and then let's rotate this on the z-axis, and I'm going to type in 180 for 180, and then hit enter. And this way it's just going to rotate the mountains over by 180 degrees so that the camera can see the back of the mountains, so it'll look a bit different from the mountains here in the background. And I can select these mountains and I can bring them forward a bit and maybe bring them down a bit. And I also want these mountains to be a bit more flat, so I'm going to hit S to scale, and then let's scale it on the z-axis, and I'm going to make these mountains much smaller, maybe bring it up a bit so they're a bit more flat. And I also want to see more of these mountains, so I'm going to scale it down a little bit just so you can see a bit more detail, and then I'll press Control A and apply the scale. Let's press Control S to save the Blender file again, and this is going to wrap it up for part 1 of the Rocky Mountain tutorial series. So I hope you've been enjoying this so far, and thank you for watching. And when part 2 is released, it'll be right up there on the end screen, and also the link will be in the video description. And as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, if learning how to create 3D environments in Blender is something that you really want to get into, then I definitely recommend checking out CG Boost's Mastering 3D Environments in Blender course. And I'll have my affiliate link to that course in the video description if you'd like to check it out. And also another great way to help support this channel is by purchasing the finished tutorial files on my Gumroad store and my Patreon page. I'll have the links in the description. So I hope you enjoyed this, thank you for watching, and I will see you in part 2.